President Trump and Joe Biden, they went head to head last night for the very last time. They clashed on everything from Trump's taxes to coronavirus and much, much more. But having looked at the markets today, there seems to be a relatively muted response here in London. But to dissect that reaction and a possible reaction stateside, we have Neil Wilson from markets.com. Hello to you, Neil.
Hi, Katie.
So as I say, plenty of clashing as expected last night, but it was way calmer than what we've seen before, certainly less interrupting, but I think that was because of that all-important mute button that they had to use. In terms of the markets here, not much reaction, right, here in London?
No, that's right. I think the market is looking at lots of different things, and the debate was certainly one of them, but I think because there was no sort of moment, there was no sense that although Donald Trump seemed to find his sort of footing a bit better than he did last time, and I think having a more subdued approach actually helped him. There was no sort of killer blow delivered to Biden or anything like that might change the polling data, and therefore we don't think there was any sort of material shift among undecided voters as a result of last night's debate, and therefore. Certainly in terms of how we think the election might pan out, there's been no change. And therefore, that, as you say, the market reaction has been quietish. And really, this morning in London, the market reaction is probably more about the Barclays earnings than anything else.
Yeah, I think you're quite right. Domestic news taking a precedence here. As you say, there was no standout blow. And actually, if you look at the polls from all sorts of different places, they're relatively the same. Like one will put Trump, a point above, the other Biden below in terms of how they performed in last night's debate. In regards to who's going to win and the market reaction, let's maybe talk about the sectors. Can you give me an idea as to who's pitching for who in terms of the oil industry, mining, retail, finance? Who's a fan of who?
Well, I think in terms of the sectors, I'd say most corporates, most sort of big bosses probably be in favour of Donald Trump if they're thinking of it from a purely earnings per share basis, their own wealth, as it were. Because Joe Biden is going to, well, it certainly if the full Biden package of tax reforms took place, you'd see an increase in corporate tax, you'd see an increase in capital gains tax, which would hit the rich particularly hard. I think clearly in terms of the oil and gas sector is 100% behind Donald Trump. I've got no doubt Joe Biden's plans for clean energy would threaten them. And I think, clearly the clean energy sector is one that stands to benefit significantly from a Democrat clean sweep. And that's the case in the US, and also clean energy companies in Europe, which are sort of something of a quiet kind of potential sort of fang type tech bubble that we could have in Europe, because we've got a lot of good clean energy sector companies here in Europe, and I think they could benefit greatly from a Biden victory. And then I guess, financials, again, you'd be looking at, as I said, I think generally speaking, they'd favour Trump purely because of the tax reforms and the certainly Donald Trump's light touch towards regulation. That sort of thing tends to be a something that corporate executives and companies tend to like.
Mm-hmm. And we have witnessed the US market surge sort of pre-COVID. He's very much used the economy as something to really rave about and something to be very much proud of. And I remember when he was first, voted in as the president, 4 years ago now, it's unbelievable. He was talking about spending, infrastructure, and that went down extremely well, as we all know. Now let's kind of get the crystal ball out and think what the markets might do if first we have a Trump victory. What will happen when we wake up the next morning? What will the markets be doing?
Well, I think the markets will there'll be volatility, I think, because I don't think the market expects a Trump victory right now. You could potentially see a rally in equities off the back of expected taxation not coming through, the higher taxes not coming through. That could be supportive of equities, but then you could see some near-term weakness because of doubts around stimulus. So one of the things that we're looking at is really the Senate race as much as the race for the White House, because if you can get a united Congress and White House, then obviously it makes getting stimulus through significantly easier, as we've seen. So if you have a Donald Trump White House plus a Democrat Senate and House of Representatives, then it just becomes that bit harder. So that could create a near-term headwind. It could support the dollar if you're looking at FX markets. Could be a positive for the dollar if Donald Trump comes in.
Mm-hmm. Now, you said that the markets aren't expecting a Trump victory. We know that Biden is very much ahead in terms of the polls, but then Hillary Clinton was at this stage as well, and we all know how that turned out. So if you're saying that the markets are expecting a Biden victory, do you think that the market reaction to his victory will be more muted then?
You've got two sort of factors there. I think what the market will be looking at is the potential for a significant stimulus bill, a sort of $2 trillion bill, which, you know, we need to remember that's 10% of American GDP. So it's a vast increase for the economy. Again, you look at whether or not there's a Senate that's in favor, because if there's still a Republican Senate, with a Joe Biden in the White House, then it becomes more problematic. And then you look at the headwinds from capital gains tax increases, which could be sort of retroactively dated to the 2nd of January 2021, when they eventually come in, and sometime later in 2021, but they could be set back, they could be retrospectively applied. And that could mean is you actually see some selling going into Christmas, because a lot of the people that would be affected by this jump in capital gains tax are the people who own stocks, obviously. So it's the 1%, and they would be minded to sell, you know, a portion of their holdings. I mean, you know, it'd be hard to say exactly what that is, but if you're seeing an increase in your capital gains tax from about 20% to about 40%, you might be minded to liquidate some positions, and that could create volatility into the year end. But then the stimulus comes in and you get, a vast amount of increase in GDP. You also get, as we saw with the first stimulus, people saving the money and putting the money to work in the stock market. So you could see sort of there's a couple of push and pull factors there. And I don't think it's exactly clear cut what the market will do the day after. I wouldn't want to put a bet on what the market's going to do the day after.
Yeah, it never is. And if we did, we'd be extremely rich, wouldn't we? Yeah. Well, Neil, we'll get you back the day after the election and find out what exactly did happen, because it's less than 2 weeks away now. That'd be brilliant. Neil Wilson there from markets.com. Thank you very much.
Thank you.